Look at this.
He's the shit.
Finally found a parking spot.
It was not fun.
After probably 30 minutes.
All the parking lots are full. I'm gonna hike to the convention.
Hike to the convention. We are about to enter our home, our land. The place where our people are. Oh, and there's a giant wall there. I thought it'd be more monumental. Dun, dun, dun. This is it. This is it. Aww. Awesome. Oh, nice.
At the very least, you can say hi.
Nice.
Yes. All right.
Awesome. Love it. He's... question mark.
Purchased
a mystery.
We don't know what's in it.
We were told there's at least 6 items in here.
At least.
A fire, it's a lid.
It's more lid.
There we go.
Oh.
Oh. Oh. Oh. And it's a box.
A valve
from
Show I Don't Recognize.
A Downton Abbey journal. Your never ending story.
That's so cute. Cool.
Donatello.
It's Doctor Who.
Jelly.
Run, you clever boy. Mortal Instruments, City Bones, Kins, and I've never watched that.
Me neither.
And now it's the sad, empty box.
Thank you so much. How's everybody doing? Good? Now, how many of us have not seen Battlestar Galactica? Raise your hand, please be honest. Okay, there's 3 of us.
I just wanted to know if you still keep in touch with any of the crew from Battlestar Galactica, if you're still friends with anyone.
As much as humanly possible, usually daily, for the last 10 years, almost 10, well, you know, it's 8 years. I do not look like Tom Cruise or Kevin Costner the way he used to look. Quite naturally. No, I've always looked like this. Okay. So, I mean, I'm actually better looking than I was when I was in my 20s. People had gotten used to it before they say, whoa, you should be a lawyer. Get into, you know, banking. Don't be in front of a camera, man. That's it. I've been so lucky because Stand and Deliver, Battlestar Galactica, Adama, Lieutenant Castillo, Miami Vice, American Me, Santana, you know, the father of Selena. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful story. Beautiful. Those are characters that I can't even tell you. What a privilege. I've lived a very privileged life.
Welcome to Waynesboro. Or Fantasy Life.
Yep.
To day 2 of Planet Comic Con, Kansas City, at the Bartle Hall Convention Center.
I think by now you know who
where
we are.
Yeah. Unfortunately, showing.
5, 4, 3. Swing! Hey, let's be creepy.
Look what's behind us. A relic
from the past. It's a payphone.
It's actually on. Oh my god. I wonder if
it's a dial
tone. Yeah, there's a dial tone.
I hear nothing. Oh, there it is.
I never fired anybody, but I wanted to say adios. it's more the attitude that I cannot stand on set. Kind of like, I'm going to say it in this way. You know how sometimes you see actors and it's like, just say example, I'm David Tennant, I'm the doctor, and you're like, and then here walks in Bozo, I'm the, you know, the Burger King king, and he's got the bigger head than David Tennant. We've dealt with people on the Hollywood show that are like, they think they're someone, and they're not, they're just nobody. So it's more of that type of attitude where you're like, you do realize you're on YouTube right now.
My show was so amazing. idea of the haka is to actually release your soul, you know, the warrior within. So you're going to try to let it all go and just face the enemy and give them your all. That means, am I going to die? Truly. Just look at them and go, kamate, kamate. Kamate, kamate. And then the next word is kaora, kaora, which means, am I going to live? So you're asking yourself the question, am I going to die or am I going to live?
Kamate, kamate, kaora.
Now you're not scaring me at all, any of you. Kiamo, which is you drop to the position and you start the slapping. And then I'll start leading the chant. But now I want you to leave everything behind and face your enemy. You're doing this for the Maoris. Come on. Ikiamo!
Kamate kora kora! Kamate kamate kora!
You gotta listen to the song.
Training necessary, but yeah, the haka is something that's integral to who I am as a Maori, you know, and so, you know, when I try to find the stimulation to play these roles, I have to sort of look within, you know, look at what I have in my bag of tools, cultural bag of tools. So I used to always do the haka, like, prior to my battle scenes on Spartacus, mm-hmm. And all the guys would be like, there's Mano again with his haka, but, you know, I just found that was the way to really anchor myself. You're okay, mate. That's what I told the reader as well. And I was like, this 5-hour energy drink was really hitting me, and I was like, oh, yeah. He said, are you ready? And I said, yeah, I'm ready. And anyway, who remembers the first scene that Slade Wilson dropped behind Oliver? And I'd hear this guy auditioning, and he's going, you got 10 seconds to tell me something I believe in. I'm going to cut out your throat box. And I was like, it's not very subtle. But then I thought about when Knight had had me in the chokehold back in Kuwait, he'd whispered in my ear really softly. He'd just gone, just relax. He gave me the 5-hour energy drink, he gave me the chokehold, and he gave me the voice that I used in this audition. Like, I always thank him for it, I'm still in contact with him. But anyway, so the guy's in front of me, and I grab him in this chokehold, and I'm like, you just hold my arm so it doesn't choke you. So I'm like, Kitty, you've got 10 seconds to tell me something I believe, or I'm going to cut out your throat box. At which point, the guy fell onto the ground. You can do it, you can just fall. The guy fell onto the ground, unconscious. And I've kind of looked up at David Rappaport, who's like the main cast, one of the main casting agents in Hollywood. And I've gone, is this part of the script? And he's gone, no, I think you just choked the reader out. You okay, kid? And he sort of did something like that. but he got up and David, thank you very much, mate. But anyway, David Rappaport told the guy to go wash his face. And then he looked at me and I really thought I was in big trouble. I didn't think I was going to get another audition in LA ever again. And I went, listen, I'm sorry, Dave. Honestly, I've just been in Kuwait, and I met a special forces guy, and this is a special forces guy, right? And he showed me that chokehold, which is in your script, and obviously it works. So you've got to excuse me. I just kind of like, you know, I just wanted to put everything into this, and I knew the energy of this guy, and I just tried to apply it, and, you know, maybe a little bit too much. But David said to me, Manu, come and take a look at this. So I went around the back of the camera, So I'm looking at it, stared at the guy, and the guy's eyes go like this. And he falls unconscious on the ground. And David said, you know what? That was really electric, and that was exactly what we were looking for. You know, he actually brought a huge reality of this we haven't seen it yet. So I think you're in for a chance. You're in with a chance. So I kind of walked out. I was just wondering whether he was lying to me. Just wanted to get me out of the room. And, you know, my manager rang, and I said, I choked out the reader. And she was like, oh, no. And I said, yeah, but they said that I might get the role. Anyway, I flew back to New Zealand. I went to the Hobbit premiere, and the morning after the Hobbit premiere, I got woken up by a phone call from my agent, and she said, Manu, they've given you the role. And it was just an exceptionally, exceptionally different scenario of how to get a role.
Picture opportunity. Predator in the woman's bathroom.
Hey guys, we're Fantasy Life Productions, and we found Miss Frizzle at Planet Comic Con in Kansas City. Look at this, she's got her magic school bus.
Yes.
This is our childhood.
It is.
So, Miss Frizzle, what is your name?
Miss Frizzle.
Miss Frizzle, I love it. I love that. Okay. So, how long did it make you? Take you to make it?
A little longer than I anticipated. To be honest, I only started about 2 weeks ago.
Nice.
So, and this was glued in the car on the way here.
Yes.
That's like the way we do it.
Just super fast.
Tweet it. Yeah.
It's really a kid's plaything. Well loved before I got a hold of it. And it's seen a few fun field trips, we'll say.
There you go. Magic field trips, right?
Magical awesome. Field trips.
Are there any celebrities here at Planet Comic that you've gotten to meet or they're excited for?
I did get to meet Jason David Frank, which the little 5-year-old part of me really loves getting to see the Green Ranger. And then
the original Green Ranger.
And I'm real excited to meet Todd McCaffrey because I love those books. And the Hollywood Show. I had fun getting to see them too.
Yes,
so,
we're excited. Well, you obviously sound like you love your nerd stuff and everything.
Love it.
You probably go to a lot of conventions.
Actually, this is only my second.
Really? Wow, awesome. Well, what kind of nerd are you, Austin? Obviously, you probably dabble in a lot of different things, but which they have more books, games.
A little bit more toward the books.
Books.
More toward the books than movies, awesome. Yeah.
Very nice. Is there a series you're stuck on right now?
Oh, I've been rereading Outlander. I love Outlander.
Very nice.
And rereading a little bit of Dragon Riders of Pern. And I just love reading. Whatever I can get my hands on.
I like it. That's very appropriate for this
puzzle. Indeed. Should.
I'm sure you teach your students well.
Reading all is about important. Being reading is important.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much.
Absolutely. Thank you.
Awesome. There's so much happening in this picture right now.
I know, right?
Oh my god.
Awesome.
Well, she's cool. Yes. Oh, so awesome. Yes. Yes. Yep, day 3.
Yep. This is our shopping day pretty much. We went inside Tom Felton this morning.
Yes.
Followed by George Takei.
Which was amazing.
Yes, he's a great book speaker.
So cool.
Awesome guy. Beautiful stories.
Yeah.
So cool.
Yesterday,
Amanda Bennett was in his panel, and he's now my boyfriend.
Yep, she went and met him.
Yeah, he's so beautiful. Just as beautiful as the essays on TV. And we had a nice little intimate conversation. And it was awesome. He was very serious and very thing. Then I told him how much I loved him more graphically. But politely. And he laughed hysterically. He grabbed my arm. And I made him laugh. So now we're going to plan your June wedding.
Yeah.
We got him off.
It
We also met the Hillywood show.
Yeah.
And they were awesome.
Yeah.
We got
really
hugs.
Sweet.
Yeah. Hugs.
Yeah, that was awesome.
That was they were really sweet.
Very cool.
Mm-hmm. Awesome call.
All the people sitting out there.
This is the end.
The end.
Leaving the convention.
Fantasy Productions, signing out.